What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. XOXO Sheba here. I have a new one from Outre's Melted Hairline. I have Harper in the color 1B. I'm ready to see what the tea is on this one. I'm so interested because it reminds me a lot of Bobbi Boss Fair, and I love Bobbi Boss Fair outside of the lace. So I'm interested to see what this one is giving. This is what the lace on this one looks like. Outre does a really good job with their lace being like a light lace, but a tintable lace. So I always love that about their units because it's able to tint down for brown and darker skin tones. You can see how much lace they're giving us in the front here. It's truly a fake frontal because that's a lot of lace space going on. And you can also check out the inside of the cap here. It's a curved part with an elastic band. And then also you have your combs throughout the wig and adjustable straps as well. Check out this hairline, y'all. This hairline, okay, like look at it. Just look at it. Like, it's amazing. They do such a great job with these hairlines. Like, that looks like I did it myself. Now, it does also come with baby hair, but it's optional to use. I pushed mine back, but you see when I push the baby hairs back, how it creates a straight line across my hairline now? I'm gonna go ahead and pluck that out. You don't have to do this if you plan on using the baby hair, but since I plan on using little to none, I'm going to go ahead and pluck out the front of that hairline so it looks more gradient and natural again. The best plucking tip that I can give you, make sure you remember this, is to keep them tweezers and your hand moving. Do not stay in the same spot for too long. That is how you create bald spots. You want to keep moving around. Now, I don't remember this being this way. You see how the line of demarcation is very clear up top between where you have your lace fake frontal area and you have that lace part area? Like, that line of demarcation is very clear. I don't remember that being there on the other melted hairline units. Drop a comment down below and let me know if you remember that being there, but I feel like it wasn't, and I just reviewed one recently and I just didn't feel like it was there, but maybe I didn't notice. I don't know. I gotta get these edges together, slicked back and laid with this edge control. I'm using my edge control that was sent to me from my first wig to slick these edges back and out of my way. When you're putting on wigs that have an elastic band, you wanna go elastic band first, then the back of the wig, then you can situate the wig how you need it to situate the wig. I see Outre is committed to this long veil-like lace. I'm not sure why it's so long, but I mean, it's not, you know, the end of the world or anything, but it's just super long. I don't know why. But anyways, back to the wig. I feel like this texture is a nice hybrid between yakky and silky. It's not too far gone on either side of those. So if you like that kind of texture, I think you'll like this one. It's a nice in-between. I did feel like the curls were kind of going every which way just a little bit. Some of the face framing ones were going inwards and I don't like that. But this is what the hair looks like before I do anything else to it. Another thing I gotta give Outre their props for is the hairline. Yet again, not just the pre-plucking job that they did, but y'all see how this dips and grooves? I love when a frontal does that already. Usually if I'm really in my plucking bag, I will do that myself on my human hair wigs. But I love that this is a like $40 synthetic wig. At the cheapest, maybe $39, but it's a $40 synthetic wig and it's got dips and grooves. Like, that is so perfect, so realistic, so on point. Now, back to the install process. When I am cutting, always remember, you wanna cut jagged. When you cut jagged, that's gonna give you a nicer lace install because it's not going to be going straight across. The fit of the wig is just as I thought, pretty spacious. If you have a bigger head and maybe you feel like it's a little tight, cut the elastic band out and you should be good. It has so much lace space, like so much lace space. And I got ear to ear coverage, you guys. Like, look at that. Look how close that's getting to my eyebrow. Now, I'm not mad at them giving us way more lace space because it's easier to customize. None of my hair has to be left out. I'm so excited, you guys. Like, look at that. All of my hair is covered. This never happens. I am using my Got To Be Glued High Insta-Hold Hairspray for this install because it's just real simple and easy to use for an install. I have my blow dryer set on cool, of course, and it really only took like a few seconds for each section that I was doing to dry. I love this product so much. They improved it a lot from the original yellow bottle. I'm wrapping my edges with an elastic band. I really like using the elastic band. I got this method off of TikTok, and I feel like it really presses the lace into your skin and gives you the ultimate melt. I really like using this. I did end up brushing out the curls. I do like more of my curls like together than separate individual curls. But I mostly took out the curls because I needed to brush out the hair that I plucked out of the unit so it wasn't getting tangled into the rest of the hair and turning into like matting and stuff. So I had to brush all that out and basically ended up brushing out the hair as well. But I liked how it looked brushed out. I'm not mad at it. Now overall, even after I brushed out any hair that I plucked out of the unit, I felt like it didn't really tangle. It did tangle a lot. But I felt like once I got rid of the hair that I plucked out, it wasn't shedding a lot. So tangling, you will have to worry about. Shedding, not so much. I ain't even gonna hold y'all. I'm really feeling this hair brushed out. Like these curls molded together, I don't know how else to word that, but put together is really starting to do it for me. Like it's just really starting to give me life. I felt like once I brushed it out, I had more like room to maneuver the hair and manipulate it the way I wanted it to be. I did feel like the top was falling a little bit flat and the curls in the front were also falling a little bit flat. So what I decided to do was pull out my scissors and add some layers to the front, just around the face framing area, so that way I could manipulate it even more and give me some more volume and movement. Because like I said, I felt like the top was a little flat and I felt like the other side was a little flat. Now, I didn't use any hot combs or wands to flatten this hair down because I felt like it was pretty flat already. But I did use my hairspray, like you're seeing me do here, to kind of mold the top and shape it. And once I did that, the top was sitting a lot better for me. To tint out this lace, I'm going in with my Maybelline Fit Me in 356 Warm Coconut. And I'm just tinting out the lace. That's all I'm doing. It doesn't take a whole lot to tint out their lace. Now, be forewarned, I do feel like it does still leave you with a bit of a lighter scalp. Or at least for me, it still always leaves me with a touch of a lighter scalp. But I feel like real scalps anyway are always a little bit lighter than the skin on your face because it doesn't get as much sunlight anyway. Now, I told y'all I had no baby hair on this one, but I did want to add some sparse, very light hairs on the front of the hairline. Very short too, just because I feel like natural hairlines have little bitty sparse hairs in the front. So I just wanted to go super natural with this, so I added some of those in too. You don't have to do this step. This is just me wanting to do something else. I'm using the same Fit Me foundation in my part, and I felt like once I put it in the part, it disguised that line of demarcation really well. I also went back and added more layers because I felt like I didn't make them choppy enough to give me enough movement in the front. I really had to kind of remix those face framing curls so they weren't going inward where they should be going outward. Also, adding the layers made them not look so flat. If you notice back at the beginning of the video, those front curls, they had a little bit of bump at the bottom, but they were still straight at the top. Adding those layers allowed it to have some more movement and look like it had more curls. I'm also adding my hairspray to the hair, using it for what it's for once. And I'm putting it on the roots to help me lift them up higher. I feel like Harper is a really subjective unit. Like, I really like it once I put some work into it. I could totally see if you didn't like it. I feel like the density is probably around like 150% density. It's not really full, but it's not too thin either, especially towards the bottom. The top, you know, I felt was a little flat. But all in all, I like the unit. If you're interested, I'll have the tee down below in the description box. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.